गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द फंडामेंटल सॉल्यूशन ऑफ लाप्लास इक्वेशन. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी डिफाइन व्हाट इज लाप्लास इक्वेशन. लाप्लास इक्वेशन इज द पार्शियल डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन गिवन बाय डेल यू इज इक्वल टू जीरो. हियर दिस डेल डिनोट्स द लाप्लाशियन ऑपरेटर. सो लाप्लाशियन ऑफ यू दैट इज गिवन बाय summation curl to u by curl xi to where I varies from 1 to n. So del u is equal to 0 is this equation summation curl to u by curl xi to is equal to 0 where I varies from 1 to n. Here x belongs to capital U. Capital U is an open subset of n dimensional Euclidean space Rn. This function u, that is a real valued function which is defined on u closure. This function is unknown function and a twice continuously differentiable function that satisfies the Laplace equation. That function is called harmonic function. Now we will find the fundamental solution of Laplace equation. To find the fundamental solution of Laplace equation, let us take the equation del u is equal to 0, which is Laplace equation in n dimension Euclidean space Rn. U is the function from u closer to R. This is unknown function. We are to find this function. And capital U is open subset of Rn. Let us suppose the solution of this equation is U is equal to V. V is the function of R here. Such kind of solutions are called radial solutions. Here R is the magnitude of X. Because X is n dimensional, it is having the components x1, x2, x3 up to xn. So magnitude of x, that is given by the square root of x1 square plus x2 square plus so on up to xn square. We are to select this function v in such a way that our equation del u is equal to 0 is satisfied. Now let us find the partial derivative of r with respect to xi. So from here, having the derivative, this will become 1 by 2 into x1 square plus x2 square and so on up to xn square whole raised to the power half minus 1 into the derivative of this expression with respect to xi. So that will become 2xi. Now 2 is cancelled with 2, and if we shift this term in the denominator, that will become xi upon r. So we have obtained the partial derivative of r with respect to xi, which is given by xi upon r. Now let us find partial derivative of function u with respect to xi. Now because u is defined to be is equal to vr, so partial derivative of u with respect to xi means partial derivative of v with respect to r into the partial derivative of r with respect to xi. Now because v is a function of r, so we can write it as v dash r, and partial derivative of r with respect to xi we have obtained, it is xi upon r. So putting the value here, we have obtained partial derivative of u with respect to xi. So this is v dash into xi upon r. Now let us again differentiate with respect to xi. So we can use product rule here. This is first function, this is second function. So the derivative of v dash, that is v double dash r, into the derivative of r with respect to xi, that is curl r by curl xi. Second function as it is, plus now v dash as it is, the partial derivative of this function with respect to xi. Now v double dash, that is as it is, curl r by curl xi, this is xi upon r. So xi upon r into xi upon r, that will become xi upon r whole square. This term as it is. Here again we can use product rule. 1 upon r as it is. Derivative of xi with respect to xi, that will be 1. Then xi as it is. Derivative of 1 upon r, that is minus 1 upon r square into curl r by curl xi, which is xi upon r. So after simplifying this, we have obtained curl 2u by curl xi 2, which is given by v double dash r into xi square upon r square minus v dash r into xi square upon r cube plus v dash r upon r. Now because we have to find the Laplacian of function u, so let us take summations on both sides from 1 to n. So left hand side become summation curl 2u by curl xi 2, where I varies from 1 to n. On the right side, taking summations, this will become the second derivative of v into summation xi square upon r square minus v dash r into summation xi square upon r cube plus summation v dash r upon r. Here I varies from 1 to n. Now, by definition, this is Laplacian of function u. This term as it is. Summation xi square, because the magnitude of x, that is r, so summation xi square is r square. So this term will become r square upon r square. Here also, summation xi square, that is r square. Because this term is added n times, so that will become n times v dash r upon r. So finally, the Laplacian of u, that is given by v double dash minus v dash r upon r plus n times v dash r upon r. We can combine these two terms. So we get Laplacian of u is equal to the second derivative of v plus v dash upon r into n minus 1. Now, del u is equal to 0 if and only if this expression is 0. So, if v dash is non-zero, then from this equation, we can find the value of v double dash r. So, that is given by the second derivative of v is equal to minus n minus 1 into v dash upon r. Because v dash is non-zero, so this can further be written as v double dash upon v dash is equal to 1 minus n upon r. Now, integrating here, after integrating, this will become log of v dash. Here 1 minus n is constant. Integration of 1 upon r with respect to r, that will become log r. Plus log a we have taken as a constant. So by using power property here, this term will become log of r raised to the power 1 minus n. So finally this equation becomes log of v dash r is equal to log of r raised to the power 1 minus n plus log of a. So this implies that log of v dash is equal to, here log m plus log n, that is log m into n. So log of v dash is equal to log of a into r raised to the power 1 minus n. So this further implies that v dash is given by a into r raised to the power 1 minus n. Now v dash means derivative of v with respect to r. So we can write derivative of v with respect to r is equal to a into r raised to the power 1 minus n. Now separating the variables and integrating. So after separating the variables, this equation will become dv is equal to a r is to the power 1 minus n into dr. Integrating, this will become v. Here there are two possibilities. If n is equal to 2, in that case this term will become 1 upon r. An integration of 1 upon r with respect to r, that is log r. And if n is greater than or equal to 3, in that case the value of v is given by a into integration of this term, that is given by 1 upon r is to the power n minus 2 into 2 minus n plus c. So if we take this constant as b, then finally the function v becomes, for n is equal to 2, this is as it is, a log r plus c, and for n greater than or equal to 3, this is b, so that will become b upon r is to the power n minus 2 plus c. So such kind of solutions, which are the functions of r, those are called radial solution. So this is the radial solution of Laplace equation, or it is also called fundamental solution of Laplace equation. So considering this expression, we can motivate the following definition. Fundamental solution is denoted by this symbol, and in particular by taking c is equal to 0, and here taking a is equal to minus 1 by 2 pi, and taking b is equal to 1 upon n into n minus 2 alpha n. This will become a standard form, which will be called fundamental solution of Laplace equation. So in general, we use this form further. So fundamental solution of Laplace equation is defined by phi x is equal to minus 1 upon 2 pi log of r, means x mod. This is the value of fundamental solution for n is equal to 2. And for n greater than or equal to 3, the value of function phi, that is given by 1 upon n into n minus 2 into alpha n into 1 upon x mod raised to the power n minus 2. And this function is defined for every x which belongs to Rn, and x should be non-zero. So this completes the topic fundamental solution of Laplace equation.